Is anybody out this week that you can say is not going to play?
No. We're good.
So all hands on deck?
Yep. Everybody who played last week will play this week. It might be, you know, we got guys from.
Yeah, but anybody who was in, anybody who suited up.
Anybody who played last week will play this week, yes.
Okay. So the announcement yesterday, was it a relief to get that kind of over with?
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to have to be, but it ended up that way. You know, it's, you know, so I'm hopefully it's I'm not going to be bugged anymore about that stuff. I don't know. Jeez. I don't know. I don't know how you try to answer questions and people still keep asking, so I don't know.
You only got asked it 4 times on Monday and then probably.
No, it was 8 times on Monday. I counted.
Yeah.
It was 8, and then I said, look, we're moving on. It was a couple yesterday. I don't know.
But, I mean, coach searches can get messy, right?
Well, they're just all over the place. And, you know, I got a commitment, you know, to this program and team and everything else, you know, and we got a game on Saturday. And, you know, it's a big honor to coach in this game and coach these guys. And, you know, it's big, you know, it's huge. It's never happened in the 128 years of Tulane football or whatever it is. You know, they've never played in a conference. Not some years they didn't have conference championships, but so this is a big deal. Excited about it.
Coach, you expect this to be the loudest crowd?
I sure hope so. I'm just, you know, I've said this on a lot of different, you know, interviews that, you know, I usually am trying to get people to come to the game, and, you know, we sold it out in 5 or 6 hours, so that's pretty darn good.
It's not a problem.
Not a problem.
Are you bullish about the long-term future? Have there been any discussion?
Well, you know, that's one of the things, you know, where we want to be able to do this consistently, you know. And I've talked to some people, and they want to get this going. Obviously, I'm busy, so I'm not, you know. But some point in time, you know, we need to sit down and hey, here's some things we can do to keep the momentum, you know. And you've been here longer. Who's been here longer?
I lived in Florida for 20 years.
Okay.
I went to my first Tulane game in 1963.
All right, so you've been here a couple of years then. You know, so you've seen it, you know, and uh-huh. we want to be able to do this consistently, and I've talked about that, you know, for a long time. There's been some great teams, been some great players, but, you know, consistently over the years, in order to do that, you got to have a plan and execute the plan, not just for the game, but for the – you know, the whole program.
Is facilities a part of that?
You know, I heard your story the other day, and you talked about that as well. Yeah, there's some things we'd like to do.
Can you be specific?
Well, there's a bunch of things. I want to talk to the powers that be about those things. But I know everybody's excited, and they can see what athletics can do for the university, and we want to, you know, be a real positive part of Tulane.
So, as far as like the NIL money, is that something that concerns you too, Coach? Or
well,
not as
I
much?
Just, you know, I just, I'll be quite honest with you, I just haven't put a whole lot of thought into much anything other than Central Florida. And there'll be something here next week. You're really about 3 or 4 weeks after we get done with the recruit, and I can sit down and talk about it and talk to the right people and all those kind of different things. But you got to have a plan. That's the big deal. And, you know, how are you going to do it? And we'll get to that later.
Can you say whether they'll extend your contract or not? Is that part of the discussion?
I don't know. You know, we'll see on all those different things, you know. So that's.
But obviously you think that this cannot be like a shooting star. You can do this on a semi-regular basis with the right things done, right?
Yeah, we just gotta, you know, we're doing a great job recruiting, and I feel like our guys do a tremendous job of representing our university and our city, you know, and it's not like that every place. Some people think it is, it isn't. One of the good things about me is I've been a lot of places. One of the bad things about me is I've been a lot of places. So I've seen it, you know, and we got good people that represent our, and that's across the athletic programs. You know, I've been some places where you're on some other teams, you're kind of like, oh man. You know, we got really, really good student athletes here, male and female.
Do you realize that you're in reach, in at least in the same zip code with being the all-time winningest coach here? Is that?
Well, I have people tell me that all the time, so that's how I know.
Is that a little slice of history that you'd like to?
Well, you know, you just. I just am laser focused on this weekend, you know. And then season gets over, we just start going after the next year. So we got a big one here Saturday, so that's all we're worried about.
Coach, I just got some inside info that in a few minutes you're going to be named AAC Coach of the Year.
Wow, that's something.
What does that honor mean?
Well, it's when you win a bunch of games, you know, I'm the representative of our team. So that's how it happens.
So,
okay. No, you go ahead.
So, the whole writing new history as the head of the program, how cool was that to be able to write all kind of things that maybe?
Well, it's great. It's just, you know, it's as I've said before, I think we got a beautiful stadium. It's the right size for us. I think when people come out and watch us play, they'll get interested, and I think we've attracted a lot of new fans, you know, and that's what we want to do, and you know, we want to, you know, continue being a highly competitive in the AAC.
Keys has really helped you.
Helped us
the
big
portal,
time.
The portal's really helped you.
Yeah, right? we've gotten some good kids. You know, I've said it 100 times, you know, these guys go away and they find out, you know, I'd rather come back home and play. And we're, I think, a very viable option for them to come back and play. And he's a great guy to have in your program. He's just a great person. And Coach Reese and Frank over there in McDonough, 35, all they ever did was talk great about him. And he's been that way for us. He's just, it's fun to have around.
He made one of the bigger plays in that game for you on Sun, because the first play of that touchdown drive, he could have gotten tackled for like a 5-yard loss.
Yeah, he had a bunch of them. He had a couple of, you know, speed sweeps where he turned a 3-yard gain into 12, 15. He's got big-time speed now, and he just can get better and better and better. Right? He's a very good football player.
Good.
Everybody good?
Good.
Thank you all. Appreciate it.